And but oh, and they made him get an animal, and so he got a cow. Named Latina. He named her Latina. And anyway, so this is the act that made my great grandpa famous. At the beginning of the circus, the ringmaster would come out and he'd go, "Ladies and gentlemen, Bobo and Latina." And my great grandpa would come walking out, shuffling out really slow, and looking miserable, pulling the cow on a string. And he'd go right up to the center of the ring and he'd stand there and do nothing. He'd just stand there. And there'd be this incredible feeling, this really crazy feeling, like filling the room of sort of like, you know, because he's not doing anything, they're just standing there. And you know when you're like really pulling for a performer, you know, you're hoping it's gonna work out, but it's not, and they're just standing there. And that crazy feeling just rose and rose and rose, and like when no one could stand it anymore, like at that exact moment, the ringmaster would come out and he'd go, "Ladies and gentlemen, Bobo and Latina." And my great grandfather would turn around and walk off really slowly, bring the cow, and that was it. Nobody would clap. And so there were lots of great acts in these circuses in those days, like so many great acts. And about midway through the circus, the ringmaster would walk out and would go, "Ladies and gentlemen, Bobo and Latina." And my great-grandpa would walk out. So he'd walk right up to the center of the ring, pulling the cow, and he'd stand there. And now people were like, okay, they're gonna do something this time. It's gonna be good. They just stood there. And now people are like, you know, Romanian circuses were tough places in those days. And people were gonna start throwing things, and everybody knew it. You know, and now people, like, their palms were getting hot, they were sweating, they were just so worked up because people were gonna start throwing things, and they really didn't want people to throw things and hit the clown and the cow because they just kinda liked that clown and they just kinda liked that cow, and they didn't wanna see them hurt, and but it was starting, and just as it was about to start, the ringmaster would walk out and he'd say, "Ladies and gentlemen, Bobo and Latina." And my great-grandpa would turn around and walk off really slowly, pulling the cow, this time to a smattering of applause as some people looked down and were surprised to find they were clapping. So, do you guys know about the old Eastern European circuses? Much? There was this thing at the end of it called the Grand March, at the end of every circus. And what it was that all the performers you've been watching all night would come down onto the ground, and it would be, you know, the acrobats, the animals, the band, like the clowns, everything, and they'd start going in a big circle doing all their acts. And they'd start off kind of slow, and they'd go faster and faster and faster, and the music would get faster and faster and faster, and louder and louder and louder. And the whole thing would just lead to this huge climax where the biggest act of all, like the act, like the one thing that the circus had that had never been seen before, that had never been done before from the deepest recesses of South America or some faraway place, would be presented, like the hook. And so everybody would pour into the center ring, and the ringmaster would rise up on the platform and he'd go, "Ladies and gentlemen, Bobo and Latina." And people would be like, and my great grandpa would walk out so slow. Just shuffle out, playing with him with a cow, out to the center of the ring. And they would stand there. And now people were like, okay, this time they're really gonna do something. God, please do something. Again, he's standing there, and people's like hearts start racing and pounding, and there's this crazy tidal wave of energy that people start feeling. And it's just rising and rising because there's going to be a riot, and everybody knows it. Like, seriously, there's going to be a riot, and they are going to tear that clown and that cow from limb to limb, and nobody wants to happen, and it's happening, but they just, I mean, because you just felt like you just kind of loved that clown, and you just kind of loved that cow, and you didn't want to see them hurt or killed, and everybody's standing up, and the riot is starting, and they would stand up to literally find themselves fighting off the entire audience all by themselves. And they turn, and every single person in the tent was doing exactly the same thing that they were. And some people started crying, and some people started laughing, and some people started applauding. And they would applaud for like 20 minutes. Like, they wouldn't let them leave. It was the loudest applause some people ever heard in their lives. And people used to gather around Latanya's pen afterwards, like teenagers waiting for a rock star's autograph. but he wouldn't tell me how it was done.